We'll see how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. After a decent run up the gut, the tailback picks up a solid 7 yards on the counter play. And they get nice yardage on that run. This is so difficult to defend.
Well, this is a perfect illustration of how to run the option, and it was perfect enough to get the first right there.
Here's the give. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
Here they come. There's the strike complete.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Brought down at about the 17-yard line. Tackled at the 5-yard line. First and goal from the 4, looking for Pater. He's taken down at the 5. Converts the extra point. An 8-play, 74-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
So the score now, 7-0. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Utah's coaching staff so confident they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big playability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big playability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
Around the 27-yard line. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Throws complete, big loss. Nothing doing for the offense, and it's fourth down. It looks like they're going to go after this punt. He really got a hold of that one. Tackle made to the 37-yard line. So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive, and until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
He steps out at the 41-yard line. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. That makes it 76. Arizona State up 7 points. Throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
From their own 47-yard line, second down. He's got it with room to run. He's brought down in the open field. Stop around the 38-yard line.
Close one there. Maybe the ball carrier will try a little harder to secure the ball next time.
From the 38-yard line, second down. Throws it into coverage and it's intercepted. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. Touchdown! The extra point to tie this game up. And he hits the PAT. Utah lines up for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Let's see how the defense responds now, coming off that big play just a moment ago.
Well, it's very important that this offense forget about the last time they were out on the field where they made that mistake and gave up the lead. They got to get back to basics here and try to reestablish their offensive rhythm.
They'll bring him down to the 38-yard line. Receiver, no good. It's third down and 5 to go. Ball on the 44. Feeds it to the back. The ball is loose. Defense says they've got it, and they do. Tackle made around the 46-yard line. That's a pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. And down he goes at the 32. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage.
That's a deep four. That makes it second and six.
down in the backfield.
This guy's out of his stance so quickly that he's really a nightmare to try to block, as they found out right here on this play.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's taken down around the 25-yard line. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
Utah is looking to go up by three. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he splits the uprights.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
10-7, Utah. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 10-7, Utah. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. The offense comes back out, and as I'm sure you'll remember, their last possession ended in a lost fumble.
The defense, I'm sure, will be aggressive again. They love going for the strip and attacking the football. He just timed the snap count there and really made a nice play.
That'll bring up second and 11.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks. It out to his receiver in a hurry.
That's good enough for another Arizona State.
Hey, kill. Three, fire.
He's at midfield. He's tackled at about the 43-yard line.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run. And that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
Here he goes. He's at the 30. And he's taken down at the 12-yard line. Decent pickup. Brought down right around the 2-yard line.
That's a gain of three on the play. That'll bring up third.
It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker.
Mike seven. Dog four.
He's gobbled up in the backfield.
This is a big-time read by this safety. You know, a lot of times as a safety, you're sitting back there making sure there isn't a play-action pass or a play potentially that can go behind you. I think this safety has that sixth sense. His instincts on that play were special. He read the run, got into the backfield, and made the play.
And it's through the uprights. Arizona State ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. A gain of 8 on the carry.
That makes it second and 2.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. He's at midfield. And he's finally taken down at the 34.
All day, Mike, two. Watch two.
He gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Three down, three down.
From the 34-yard line, it's second down. Nearly intercepted.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers. So that was a really good effort.
They get 3 yards on the play.
Nice grab there by the tailback to at least move the ball forward for some positive yards.
It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Utah could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks away.
And he got it.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
Second and 12 coming up here.
Ball on their own 23.
Tight right, tight right. Four down, four down. Green.
It's a fumble. And it's picked up by one of the linemen.
First and 10, ball on the 39.
Red two.
And he's tackled at the 48.
I think it was a great play call. It was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Yard line.
Number 27 on the tackle at the 38-yard line. First down.
Watch one. Easy.
And off, and he's met immediately.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Mike seven.
Black kill.
Black five.
Panther two.
At the 34-yard line. And they make the stop at the 23-yard line. He launches one for the end zone. Swatted away. And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Seven's a Mike. Mike seven. That's right, baby. They don't want it. Red two. Go.
Quick throw incomplete. Wanted his receiver.
They came up short here trying to pick up the first down, but they still are in field goal range, and they're going to try to come up with 3 points.
So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and it's good. Arizona State is lining up to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And they can forget about returning this one.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a t-shirt that says finish, finish. Whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to the opponent's territory.
They'll bring him down at about the 31. That's a nice 6-yard gain.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Caught, and big hit there to stop it.
Boy, that hurts the offense to have to go 3 and out. They're going to have to think about how to get something going the next time they come out.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down at the 33-yard line.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
Passing into coverage, and this one's going to be picked off. And the quarterback just can't believe it. He really wishes he could have that one back.
Every quarterback has passes that he wishes he could have back. However, hey, a pick is a pick, and no one is going to care how bad he wants that one back.
From the 44-yard line, first down. On the draw, Utah is going to have to use their second time out of the half.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
So with the half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. The distance, and he missed it right. No good. The offense comes out to start this drive, and they're hoping for a better result as they threw a pick on their last possession.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
He's all the way home. Touchdown. And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
And boy, did he ever show some reflexes to snag that thing after it was tipped.
And he adds the extra point. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Sun Devils with a touchdown lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half, and boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
But you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this grave. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
I can only hope that Nessler and Herbstreit will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
by Reese David. Thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Arizona State's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line. They come out on an empty backfield. Nice run up the middle. Gets to about the 44-yard line. The running back gets two on the carry. That makes it 7-8. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. 1 yard loss for the halfback.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And he's tackled at the 24.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
Arizona State up 7 points. He gets rid of this one. It's 2nd and 10. Ball on their own 24. Fires complete over the middle. And down he goes, around the 30-yard line. At the 20, and he's taken down at about the 15-yard line. The 10 slides down. Touchdown, Sun Devils.
Boy, he looked determined running the football. Nobody was going to keep him out of the end zone.
And he converts the extra point. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Pass! And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Quick throw out to the receiver.
Tackle made at about the 33-yard line.
Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
But they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's tackled.
Right around the 48-yard line.
They come out in a five-wide set.
They go. Check, check. Disco Raver. Disco Raver.
There's a strike complete.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
In the shotgun and five wideouts.
They bring him down in the backfield. Five wide. Brought down
around the 31-yard line.
That's good for 15 yards.
First down. Check three, check three, check three. Choose the mic.
Hands off left, and they got him behind the line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss. It's second and 12. Ball on the 18-yard line.
You're not going to see this very often from this running back. He just got gobbled up pretty deep in the backfield.
It's the 11th play of the drive. First down, Graham. He's out of bounds at the 2-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Utah! And he hits the PAT.
It was a 12-play, 74-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Fred, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 27-20. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Wow, close game here, and up and down the field with both these offenses matching what the others done.
Well, it's fun to watch each offense get an opportunity to go out and make plays, and you're right, you almost feel as if one offense feels challenged and has to be able to bounce back, and they've done that. I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Arizona State is up a score. Just throws this one away. From their own 30-yard line, it's third down.
That QB's trash.
receiver. It's the sophomore. Out to around the 45. His way to about the 32. So at the end of three, the Sun Devils in front, 27-20. First down. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Taken down at the 30. Arizona State is up by a touchdown. Stop right around the 26-yard line. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
So it's fourth down. They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, looks long enough, and he splits the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it two touchdowns in two possessions. He's got it with room to run. And he's tackled at the 38. Makes the tackle.
Gain of 13 on the play. First down.
Up the middle for a nice gain.
Nothing better than having an athletic, versatile, and instinctive safety. He makes a big-time play here with his recognition of the run, comes up and does what he does best, which is make a nice, sure tackle on the ball carrier.
Third and nine. Ball on the 39. Complete. Brought down. Nothing doing.
Why in the world would the offense run around short for the first down? That just baffles me every time I see that.
Out here, and he is drilled at the 45-yard line.
Number 12 with the tackle at the 45-yard line.
Just under three to go in regulation. And he almost has the INT.
The defense always likes to see a pass broken up, but getting the turnover would have been really big.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. They'll bring him down around the 26-yard line.
Number 18. First down.
Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. It's the ninth play of the drive.
That makes it second and ten.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. Kicks up, and it's good.
Great snap and a perfect hold, and he just had an awesome follow-through. Everything went right there on that long field goal.
30-23, Arizona State. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Sun Devils
have been rolling on offense, and they look at the scoreboard, and it's still a tight ball game.
I can't believe that this is still a close game. As you said, they have such a huge advantage, and yet it's a tight game. They've just blown too many opportunities.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Just over 2 minutes in the game. And he just gets rid of it. From their own 25-yard line. Second down.
Green nine.
Fires out to his wideout.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
Makes it to the 47.
Very intelligent play call. Dialing up the option on third down, and it worked like a charm.
From their own 47-yard line, first down. He gets out to about the 44-yard line. Utah's called their final timeout. And he's tackled at the positive yardage. First and 10. Ball on the 37.
Right, two, three, nine. Run.
Gets out to around the 28. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. Here's the eighth play of the series. Arizona State is up 7. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, 30-23. Arizona State. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kurt and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.